In this video, I will show you what variables are and how to use them when coding in JavaScript. What are variables? A variable is a container that stores some type of value. Now, if we think back to math, algebra, we learned that A plus B equals C, and we were taught that this could, for example, stand for 1 plus 3 equals 4. So these variables of A, B, C could stand for whatever value we would assign to it. So this is also true when we're coding with JavaScript. But something else is also true, because in JavaScript, we can work with more than just numbers that we store in variables. We can also work with things like strings or written text. So this could literally also mean in JavaScript, pumpkin plus pie equals pumpkin pie. Okay, so it's just whatever value that I store in that variable is what will be or what will live in there. How do you write variables? What we see here is the variable head of sales being assigned a value, Jane. So we start out with our keyword. In this case, we're using let, but further along in this video, I will show you other ways or other keywords you can use to create variables. Then we have our variable name or identifier, head of sales. Now you might see this is written a bit special. This is something I'm gonna touch on also a bit further along in this video. Then we have our assignment operator, which is just an equal sign. And then our value, in this case, it's text. So we call this string, and you can use either single or double quotation marks, and then semicolon. Now, the semicolon isn't always 100% necessary when you're writing JavaScript, but to make sure that for the times where it is necessary that you don't miss out on it, I just suggest to always use it. Always use a semicolon. Okay, now let's test this out, and I want you to follow along, and that's why I'm going to keep it as simple as possible and use my browser to write JavaScript. So I'm going to have this tab here, right click on it, and I will choose inspect. Now I'm working in Chrome. You can do the same thing in Edge, in Mozilla. They all have kind of like developer tools or something like that. On Chrome, it's called inspect. Now, in order for you to be able to actually read what I'm writing, I've already increased the font size here in this view. If you want to increase your size, if it's on a Windows, it's Control plus. If it's on a Mac, it's Command plus, once you have these developer tools here open. Now switch over to the tab console and let's start typing let name equals and then your name. Make sure to write it in quotation marks, either double or single, and then hit enter. Now you'll get back as what is called a return value undefined. That's normal, that's perfectly fine. How do we check if the assigning of the name to the variable name actually worked? Well, simply type in name, hit enter, there you go, hit it again, and then you're gonna be on the new line and you see that it gave us back Chanel. How about we try out a different variable? Maybe something that we can calculate with. Let's type in let year equals, let's say it's 2022, semicolon, enter. Okay, so again, same exercise. If you type in year, hit enter, you'll see it'll give you back 2022. It's the following year. How will we add plus one? Now, you might be tempted to do the following. Year plus one, it gives me back as a return value 2023, so it seems that all is good. But it's not, because now if you type in year and say, give me back the current year, it's 2022 again. So are we like back to the future or something? Well, if you wanna assign a new value, so based on the value you already have, in this case 2022 and at 1 year, then you would do it the following way. You would say year equals, because we're assigning a new value of whatever was already in year plus one, let's write the semicolon just to make sure it's correct. And now if we check again what's in year, I'm betting, there you go, it's 2023. Now, I would like to show you something that you might see if you're maybe copying a JavaScript from somewhere, maybe a code snippet, sometimes you'll see someone creating a variable but not assigning a value because they're going to do that further down the line or further down in the script. And that is absolutely valid. So let's try this out. Let's say let new year. I'm just writing something random. So I've just created new year. And if I now check what's actually in new year, it says it's undefined because it has no value. And now I could go ahead and say new year equals, let's say 2024, enter. And now when I check for new year, I'm just gonna use here to autocomplete. Then we see it contains 2024. Three options to declare a variable. Now we have three different keywords we can use to define a variable, and they also all create a little bit of different variables. So let's start out with const, the constant. This we use to create a variable which will contain a value that will not change. When would you use something like this? Well, think of your having an ID, maybe a passport number of someone. You're creating an app and all of the people have to add in their passport number. That is something that many countries doesn't change. In that case, it might be a good option to store it in a variable that was designed or defined as a const. Var, now this is what you will most commonly see. This was the traditional way of saying I want to create a variable. And my suggestion is whenever you find a code snippet or maybe even a script that you just want to adapt to your needs, stick to var if it already contains var. Let is the newer way. By the way, const is too. So let and const were both introduced, I believe it was in 2015. And it's a newer way of creating a variable. In certain ways, I would say it's a little bit superior to var. So there are certain technical details between var and let that are a bit different. If you're interested in finding out what those details are, if we can get 10 times the comment var versus let on this video, I'll make a dedicated video just about that, demonstrating why these two are different. Now, I personally love creating variables with let. I feel comfortable with that. But you might also want to start out with using const as the default way to create your variables and just use let whenever you know you're going to be creating a variable that somewhere in your script will receive a new value so that the value will be changed. Okay. Now, as said, var and let have technical differences. Please, as a takeaway from these three different ways to create variables, never exchange var for let in an existing script because there are technical differences and it could lead to your code not running as expected. Let's see how or what happens when we try to reassign a constant or new value to constant. By the way, I got rid of all of the other variables by clicking here on clear console. So let's say const equals revenue like so, and let's say, I don't know, some random number. There you go. And now we want to say, okay, revenue plus, you know, whatever new revenue we generated. There you go. And plus some random number like so. And I did it again. Obviously, that's not what I wanted to do. So let's do this, revenue like so. Equals, now we're talking revenue again, because as you remember before, that was just on the fly, but not actually assigning a new value. Now we're saying, please store in the constant of revenue, whatever already was in revenue, plus this 5-4 and so on and so forth. And now we're gonna get back an error. By the way, error messages, understanding them, crucial when you're learning any programming language. So what we're seeing here, uncopped type error, assignment to constant variable at 1 of 9. So very often here, or in the error message, depending where you're writing it, maybe you're writing it in a script editor, or you know, any coding editor, it will give you the actual line of code where the error is happening. Now here for us, it's clear it's the line right above, and it's telling me I'm assigning to constant of variable, It's not very clear, the error message, but what it's trying to tell me is, hey, this is a constant. You can't just go ahead and reassign any other value because it already contains a value, okay? So uncaught type error and the rest what you see there usually means you're reassigning a value to a constant, and that is not allowed because constant, you assign a variable value once and that was it. JavaScript identifiers. So when you create your new variables and you want to give them an identifier or a name, please be aware of that the name can contain letters, digits, underscores, and dollar signs, but it should begin with a letter. It could also begin with a dollar and an or an underscore, although I don't recommend that. So whenever you create variables, I would suggest you stick to creating a name that begins with a letter. Why not a dollar or an underscore if it's technically possible? The reason is that a lot of the libraries that you can use to extend JavaScript that give you extra functionality have special methods. This is something that I will teach you what they are in a future video. So they have special methods that start with underscore and dollar, and that could lead to confusion. So just stick to letters. Now, JavaScript is case sensitive. So name with a capital N and a lowercase n is not the same thing, is not the same variable. Please keep that in mind. There are certain words you're not allowed to use when you're creating a new variable, and they're keywords. So keywords are words that are part of the language JavaScript that you use to do certain things like if, else, function. These are all keywords. And by the way, in future videos, I'll show you how to use all of them. Now, when you're writing a variable name, it's best practice to use camel case notation. This is something that you will not find in all of the programming languages. They all have their own nuances. Camel case is something that you will find in JavaScript, but not in Python, not in Ruby, not in Java, and so on and so forth. Camel case stands for the first letter of the word of the variable name or identifier is lowercase and the second word is uppercase. So that's how you see camel case, which would actually be two words, would be the first C small, the second C big. Okay, so whenever you're creating a variable name that contains multiple words, please use camel case. Now here are a couple of examples of, on the left side, good variable names, which I would advise you to use. And on the left, well, not so good variable names, which as a matter of fact would even lead to an error if you were to try them out. In our next video, we're gonna find out what type of values we can store in the variables that we just learned how to create. So make sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel by hitting subscribe below so that you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos.